Rasha says, Yankov Esav, or Amir and Beparsha, El told us Yitzchak ben Avram, Avram Hoel et Yitzchak. Rasha says, Yankov Esav, Amir and Beparsha. And we find all along the whole Parsha is Rivka Heves is Yankov, Yitzchak is Esav. Yankov takes the Bechor away from Yankov takes away the Bruches. Yankov says, Anoichi Esav Becharechu, Hayidayim Yidei Esav, Vayurach Esreich Begudov. And at the end of the day, Yankov is Emes, and Esav is Sheker. How does it go? Esav, we see all along, is Echmas and Sateven, Esmach, Ramelach, Kibbad Avem, very humanistic person. And Yankov from day one is Yudah Chezis. From day one is Yudah Chezis, Bakav Esav. The Lele Rebbe Zechayim Ruch used to say, why did Yankov hold on to the feet from Esav? What did you want to accomplish with that? Esav has to go out first, so it makes no difference. You can hold on the feet and not you can hold on the feet. So I used to say that the Mechumah with the Yetzer Hara, you don't make any accounts if it will be Metzliach, not be Metzliach. You have to fight him. Don't think it's going to work or not going to work. Just like here, nothing's going to help. What are you holding on to there? When it comes fighting the Yetzer Hara, there's no chesbonos. V'raya says, at the end of the day, Yankov got the Bruches, Yankov got the Bechor, Yankov got anything. Why was that? Because he was fighting Esav in all kinds of ways, even ways that didn't make any sense. And there was no chance in the world that he could accomplish it. Where do you learn it from? The Busha says you have to learn it from the Yetzer Hara himself. It was Yochanan and Kohen Gudl that became, at the age of 80, he was so. You think the Yetzer Hara came to Yochanan and Kohen Gudl at the age of 80? Say the Busha, no. He was working on him 365 days a year, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's all kept on working. Was he Matzliach? What are you doing? Yochanan and Kohen Gudl, you know what to do? It's all. But he didn't look. He just kept on going till the age of 80, he called him. So we also have to think the same thing when we fight the Yetzer Hara. Also, we don't have to make a cheshbon how it's going to work. You have to fight him because you have to fight him. So actually, we always know Yankov is Emes, and the Torah you find just the opposite. Takes away the Buches, takes away the Bechorah, all kinds of and Esav is the Emes, Esav is Sheker, and all you see in the Torah, how nice he is, how humanistic he is. The answer is, Sfasem is as a unique way to answer. But first we'll explain, why did the Kodesh Baruch Hu make that Yankov and Esav should be together in one womb? Ain more bears. Hoysa bears up his chibutim of Zushim, Yankim of Fachasus. Well, Pishavi de Zur, Esim of Fachasus. So what's going on here? So, why the Kushbuch have to do this in one stage? You can make Yankim should be born, and a year later, Esav will be born. Was brand that it should be together? The answer is, we find this week in the Parsha about the Be'eris, that we were young, Yitzchak was looking for Be'er Maim. First one was Asik, the second one was Sitnu, and the third one was Rehovos. Asik, they were fighting around, and then we go into another one, was Sitnu, they were fighting around again, till they came to the third one, was Rehovos, Atu Hirchev Hashem Luni. That's what Samuel says, what's the difference? Because only by the third one they said, Hirchev Hashem Luni. They reminded that it's the Rebbe Shlavs. Till they were saying, Luni Amayim. So Luni, we'll show you whose it is. So it didn't work out. But a person has to know, when he starts off in Avodas Hashem, suddenly he has conflicts within himself. Am I accomplished? Am I able? Am I possible? Am I... Will I, won't I? A person is all the time busy with that. And good mechavero, it's a good lemon. The more he wants to go in, the more he has the hardships. And a person always says, oops, so when am I going to get rid of this? And Rush used to say that it doesn't get better, the matzav gets worse. He used to say, look at me, I can tell you the matzav gets worse. He used to say, a person that lives with all day busy with COVID. So he used to say, but by his levaya, everybody will be crying, and he'll still be busy with the COVID. Who's first and who's second? The Gemara said, "Ad zebile basaisa," to the last shovel will be put on the nifta, he'll still be busy with that. That means that a person has to recognize that is part of his advancement. The way a person advances is only through the hardships that he goes through. Without any hardships, the kishlonos, the failures, can be taken as a failure of my esteem, but it can also be taken as a learning of how to cope, how to advance, how to build my personality. The more hardships a person goes through, the more his personality is shaped, more his strength is revealed. So that's called Asik. Asik means that a person recognizes that this is a war forever. This war won't end. This war, that's why Kodesh Baruch Hu put Yankov and Asik in the same womb. That person should know whatever you're going to do, Esav is there. He's not going to eliminate. The Baal Shem Tov once asked, we say by Yom Kippur, Moich alavoy nesamah beisiz zor mavash meseinim chol shunam. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu was Moich al ol alavoy nes. And then Amotzi Yom Kippur, Slach lo nevini. Well, what happened? HaKadosh Baruch Hu just finished. So the Baal Shem Tov said he counted 400 gumim, that he was pregnant against the Shefa from when it Motz Yom Kippur to his Hatzlach. 400 Pgumim. That means some things that he, and his Madrega that went wrong. And that means you just step out of Yom Kippur and he's back there. And he's still is a full force. That means that a person has to recognize. Once a person recognizes that is, Yiddish say, they say something, a person, sometimes a person gets down, gets broken, gets disturbed. Why am I getting disturbed? But that's not a person has to be, if something is disturbing him, he has to recognize that is part of him that he has to cope with. But don't be disturbed. Why am I being disturbed? Don't be saying, oops, it's always here again, because he's there because to give me strength, to give me. So once a person accepts that, then suddenly he goes into Avodas Hashem, fighting the best he can, because he's fighting for himself, he's fighting for his life. Suddenly, he has a new problem. All his friends, his family, siblings, all the ones that know him from before, start asking him, well, what happened to you? Is something wrong with you? You became a chusid, you became a... And then tells you, say, you became a fag. That's what he's saying, tells. Well, what happened to you? So suddenly he's sitno. All his surroundings are getting against him. So the Torah says again, you have to recognize that that is also part of the procedure. It's part of the procedure in order to get the Elul Sashareka. Then a person can come to Choyves, he can come to Harchuva. So this part of Yankev and Esev, this goes together, all together, all along. We say by davening, V'sim Chalkeinu Imuhem. By על הצדיקים ועל החסידים ועל זיק נשאי סמכו בייס איסור ועל פלייטס בייס אופן ועל גר הצדיק ועל איני המלך ושים חלקני אמון וזה ערי says that when we say ושים חלקני אמון, what does that mean? רבוני שלולם, I want whatever merits, whatever שכר I get from my mitzvahs, give it away for the צדיקים. I don't want, give it for them. ושים חלקנו על החלק that we have to get. Give it away to the tzaddikim. Zugdari, why? Because a person falls, a person does averes, if a person doesn't go according to the Torah, and he's a b'chinah for Arusha, all his mitzvahs go away to somewhere else, to the sitracha, to the evil. So might as well give it away to the tzaddikim. Let them have a to'elis from it. And what will I have from it? The minute I do tshiva, the tzaddikim will give it back to me, because you can trust them. They don't need it. They have enough of their own. They don't need it. So v'sim chalkeini emum, I give it away for them in order that when it comes the right day that I return to myself, I'll always find it, that they kept it and watched it, and they'll give it back to me. It won't get lost. That's what Ari says. So Yitzchak Ohav is Esav. They say that Yankiv Mufachas Lutzes, Esav Mufachas Lutzes. There were two types of ways how to deal with the Banshlam. Yankiv said, you just sit in shul, don't go out, and things will work out. Asa says, no, you have to go into all these places, onto these pubs and all this, and turn them over, and we have to bring them all back to Yiddishkeit. So it's actually two. It means Asa had a good element within himself. I had a gefährliche Wort, and the Talmud Rebbe, Dein Gesentin Yishalayim. He said, Rashi says, Lahoye nikurim b'maseihem, v'yigdili hanu'urim, no one recognized who they are. The minute they grew up, then Esav went to his way and Yankov went to his way. He told the Rebbe, why does Rashi tell us that? He says the house of Yitzchak Avini was a house of Torah, a very busy house, always guests coming, going, and etc. And suddenly comes home the children from Cheder, Yankov and Esav, and no one has time to them because it's very busy, people coming, going, and busy Mekarev, and etc. Yankov was a quiet boy, Ishtom, Meshavulim. He was sitting on his books and eating the books, as you say, and reading, and he didn't need any attention. Esav, he was a very curious. He was very emotional. He needed a lot of attention. Nobody paid attention to them. So that's what happened when the minute he became big and he found where he can get his attention, it was already too late. His Yanke stayed where he was, so that means that we must give the attention. But Esav had, when Yitzchak Ohav is Esav, he saw the potential that Esav has. that pnimi is that he can turn over a world and bring all of them back to avodas Hashem, which Yaakov didn't have that potential. And that's actually what Yitzchak liked about Esav more than what Rivka liked about Yaakov. And that's actually what we need. Yakir v'yedi kol yoyz v'sevel k'luchuticha k'beach t'shuv v'chalushim. But it went wrong. But even goes wrong, the bruches that Yitzchak wants to give to Esav, because Yitzchak held it belongs to Esav, because he's the one that's going to bring the whole world to Hashem. But once Yitzchak is, Esav is off track, so who does all the mitzvahs and mas and tovim go zogdari? It all goes over to the tzaddik. It all goes over to Yaakov. So actually, Vayilbesh is begudav. Whatever Esav was supposed to get went automatically to Yaakov. Is Rivka put on the begudim from Esav and Yaakov? Because once he didn't go according to the way he was supposed to go, automatically went that. And actually, when he said, Hayudayim yudei Esav, Noichi Esav b'charechu, because he got all the merits, all the Olam Haba, everything that was prepared for Esav was there. Anything that shaykh to the Torah of Esav b'charechu was now part of Yaakov, actually. And Svasemis goes noch weiter, that if Esav would have surrendered himself and would have accepted that mahalach, and he would do tshiva, Yaakov would give it back to him. Yaakov doesn't need it. So Esav actually did another failure when he decided to declare war on Yaakov. But if he wouldn't have declared war for Yaakov, Yaakov was ani shulaim v'chi adaba heimu lamalchumu. The Yaakov Avini wanted to give it back to him in Parshas Vayishlach. He started sending him all sign, book, whatever he had, he started sending him. He tried to explain him. Nothing went lost. It's here. Adrabe. I did you a favor that I took the bruches. Because if I wouldn't have took the bruches, it wouldn't have gone lost to the sitarach, it would have gone lost to the evil, and none of us would have had. So that now that I got it, I'm just holding it as a deposit for you. And what are you angry about? But Yankovini loy guzales Esav, like Adarab, who mekabel habruche lechol oilem. He got the bruche for the whole world. And that's what he told to Esav. Mishmane hu uretz yem shevechu, vesuchichu tavod, ki loy sechses hamavikeshachu, whatever you need, you're going to get. And mevikesh on Yankov, praktzich et ha-shoresh, you only need the roots of it, but the lemaisi, you're going to get it all. I'm trying to explain him. Listen, the Gemara says, when the Goyim would know how much Hashpua they have out of the Beis HaMikdash, they would put up a big fight neged Nechadnetzah that destroyed the Beis HaMikdash, because their Hashpua actually comes from the Beis HaMikdash to them. And now that it's destroyed, they destroy for themselves. As a maiden, we come back to our question that actually Yaakov is emes. And not only emes, he was ready to give away from himself back to Esav, not to keep it at all. Mashenki, Esav, with his sheker, he couldn't accept that what he is, and he couldn't accept that someone else should hold mine. So not only he didn't get, but even lost what he was able to get. So the Yaakov kept it. And they, Montreal, the Vision Sabbath was in New York, and they're calling to Montreal. They had a big chusa there. Made a very big Shabbos. And the whole town came for Shabbos, Friday night. Shabbos. And the main thing was Motzei Shabbos and Lava Malka, Tachlis. And The whole town was with invitations and placards. Came out to Shabbos, there were two people by the Malav Malka. The Vision Tzereba and the person that made it. And they were sitting there till Masa, and they went home. In those days, we're talking 50 years ago, there was a daily newspaper in Yiddish, used to go out, a shtickl blätter. So this Halpin was his name, put out an ad, and he wrote how nice the Shabbos was. Vision Sebel was in Montreal, and was on a Friday night at Tish in the morning. And the biggest part of the Shabbos was Motzei Shabbos. Thousands of people came into the hall and weren't able to move and this and that. We couldn't make cider and this and that. So Vision Sebel says, I said, what are you doing? Are you making fun out of me? Nobody was there. To have you see what happened. So on the next day, everyone comes to the Vision and says, oh, I heard there was such a big oil. I'm sorry, I couldn't come over here. I have to take a check. I'm take a check. If everyone was there, and I wasn't there, I was saying, לגדלום, לחופה, לחופות, אהלן טוב, זה שכח.
שמואל נשוי עם יעל, הייתה אצלנו, יעל, אני חושב הייתה גם אצל הרבן, יעל מהונגריה והולנד.
כן, כן, אני זוכר, הייתה בשער, יום כיפה פעם אחת אצלנו.
נכון, נכון. שמואל לבעל, עכשיו נולד ברוך שם ארבע חודשים, יש להם...
ושמחה כן מימואל. רגע, אם שמו את החלק של אימואל,
Now you're a noob shot altogether.
I'm not going to be a Tom.
הוא היה תום, מלשון שלמות. לא מלשון שהוא היה קטי.
אוי, שמורכם.
הוא היה חתיכת ג'אבה, הוא...
תסף פחד להתעסק.